G'day BIs, my name's Stephen Doherty and I'm from Market Grunt. This is a two-part series on how to use the Google or Bing API to geocode your address list. You're probably aware that most visuals in Power BI require your location data to be in a geocoded format. In this demonstration, we'll take this 100-row table of addresses and convert them to a geocoded list using Power Query in Excel and the Google API. In part two, we'll use the Bing API and do a comparison of speed and accuracy between the two. Let's get started. To begin with, you'll need to get a Google API key. The address to navigate is indicated here. Log in using your Google account details. Note that when you set up an account, you'll need to supply a credit card because both Google and Bing are a pay-for-use service. However, both have generous free use levels. Note that during Google setup, you'll need to define the API, what it's going to be used for, and in this case, I will be using it for the In the Places category. When completed, your API will appear in the credentials part of your account. Remember to keep your API key confidential. And here are the steps we are going to be taking to set up the Google geocoding. I call this the load and refine stage because sometimes the table we have may need further adjustments before it can be used by the Google and Bing APIs. It's important to know the input requirements for the APIs, as in this case, Bing requires input in one format while Google requires it in another. Let's load this table into Power Query. And to do this, I go to Data, From Table Range. The data that the Google API will use is in the location column. However, I know from the API documentation that the accuracy of the API can be improved if a country code or description is included in the address, which is currently missing from the location data. I include this information by adding a custom column and appending the ISO code for Australia to the end of the location data. Note the address parts are separated by commas. We delete the old location column and rename the custom column to location. And when complete, we hit close and apply. The newly created spreadsheet with the table we'll rename to output. The next step is to create the Power Query geocode function. A Power Query function is a stepwise process that you want Power Query to undertake with each row of data in your table. In this case, we want Power Query to take each address and pass it through to the Google URI and return the geocoding data. To do this, I take a copy of an example of the location data I want processed by the API and paste it into a spare part of a spreadsheet. I now need to place the location sample into an input format that the URI will recognize. To do this, I copy and paste the API template from the Google documentation and paste it into the API cell on the spreadsheet. Clean it up a bit to get it all in one line. And then copy and paste the location details into the API location section. Remember to use quotation marks to embed the details as text. Next, we copy and paste our API key from our credentials into the API template. And this is what our URI call to the Google API ends up looking like. Now that we have a complete URI, we can use this to return location data from Google. To do this, I copy the URI and select Get Data from Web and paste the URI and select OK. If the URI is successful, you'll see this dialog box. Select the Transform Data button and the Power Query window will open. Let's go over and rename the query name to something a little bit more memorable. Next, we will commence editing the details returned by the API call. I'll start by expanding the result column to show the columns in the returned API table. The information I'm after is in the highlighted columns, formatted address and geometry. As we'll see, formatted address is a column of data, while geometry returns another table. I also make a mistake here that you don't need to follow by not deselecting the column name prefix setting. And in the next few steps, I correct the mistake and remove the prefix from the formatted address column. Next, I expand the geometry table and select location, and then expand geometry location to retrieve the lat and long columns. And at the end of the process of expanding and extracting, we have three columns of data, one showing the formatted address and the others being the latitude and longitude returned for the formatted address. Why I want these three will be demonstrated shortly. So just recapping what we've done so far, we've created a sample API call, we've created a Power Query step with the call, and we've extracted and shaped the data from the API. And next, what we're going to do is convert all these steps we've created in Power Query and turn it into a Power Query function. Most of the next stage of development will happen in the Query Editor, which can be found in the Home or View tab. Open the Query Editor. We begin the function creation with another let statement above the current let statement and type in the parameter that will be passed by the function to the API call already in the Power Query steps below, and end the statement as shown. Having created the location parameter, we are now going to place it in the API call. I do this by replacing the current address in the query with the variable called location, which we created in the parameter. Note that we wrap the variable called location in ampersands so it can be concatenated with the API call step. We finish the creation of the function with a concluding statement of in and the variable name. And when completed, click Done. We see the query is now transformed into a function as denoted by the function symbol, and our function now prompts for a variable called location as its input. Our function is now complete, and the next step is to invoke it in our table of addresses, which we created earlier. Note that we have a column in our table called location, which has the detail we require to pass to our API function. We pass this detail by adding a column to our table and invoking a custom function. In the function query box, we select the Google API function we created. Next, we define which column the function is going to take its input from. And in this case, it's the location column, and click OK. Here we see the return table for the call to the API function. A function has returned some errors, as can be seen here. We will need to identify why these errors are being returned. And unfortunately, you can't filter for an error in Power Query. Instead, we'll need to test the error condition using the try function. To do this, we add a custom column and add the function to the API column and enter OK. We expand the return table to reveal two columns. We select the has error column and enter OK. We can now filter this column to show any errors returned by the API function by selecting true. We now see all the rows in the table that returned an error. What seems to be happening here is the API is rejecting the abbreviation for corner or CNR. So let's reverse our Power Query steps to a point where we can add an additional step to remove CNR from locations. I do this by replacing CNR in the locations column. Once that's done, we can continue the Power Query steps and expand the Google API function. Do a quick inspection to see if there are any errors. And select the formatted address and lat long columns. And there we have it. Everything appears okay. So let's close and apply to see what's returned. We can see that the query is running. I'll cut it here and come back when it's completed.
A few moments later.
And 74 seconds later, we have an output table. However, although our input table was 100 rows, our output is 109 rows. This means we have some addresses that Google could not find matches to, so it's included approximations to the input addresses. We can identify these approximations by seeing where the duplicate values are in the output table. Here I use an Excel function to conditionally color duplicates of the store name and then filter the output by the color. We can see from the filtered results that there are two stores that the API has problems with. With the Gilgandra store, we can see the location address that was passed from the function to the API and what the API returned as the formatted address. The latitude and the longitude are the coordinates to the formatted address. So in this case, none of the coordinates relate to our input address. I suspect the reason for this is Warren Road is concatenated, while the address in Yarra Glen returned not only the correct result, but also a similar result from the same area. Depending on the number of mismatches, you can either edit the original input table and rerun the query, or manually adjust the output table. Gone through a few steps to create a Power Query Geocode function using the Google API. We started off with an API sample call and then use that within Power Query as a step. We then extracted and shaped the data from the API call and created a Power Query function from the sample call. We then invoked this function with our input data and then ran the query to our output table and verified the return results from the original input. That concludes how to create a geocode function in Power Query using the Google API. The next demonstration will be on the Bing API. I don't expect that demonstration will be as long as many of the steps are similar and won't need as much explanation. Let me know if there's any feedback or points that require further explanation. See you next time.